tail of the tape for our next fight, a heavyweight fight. Dream Boxing rules. This one could be a slugfest.
Ladies and gentlemen, KOK Fight Series 2019, live on KOKFights.tv. Professional boxing fights, and this fight are supported by Latvian Professional Boxing Federation, President Andrei Akhmedov, and Supervisor Yekaterina Krylova. Professional boxing super fight, blue corner, fighter representing Latvia, Eriks Kalashnikov.
The big Latvian heavyweight, the 29-year-old AK-47, Eriks Kalashnikov, has a professional record of 9-7-1 and tipped the scales at 108 kilos before this fight. That is a 13 kilogram weight difference between him and his opponent in his favor. So is that going to work to his advantage to drop some heavy gloves in there?
Kalashnikovs, Latvia. Ladies and gentlemen, red corner from Latvia, Vadim Trikhamirovs.
Hey yo, you niggas must be out your fucking mind. Yo, think a dog can't tell another motherfucker. Yo, rapping out the hat. Think I ain't gonna trip up my motherfuckers. Deep you bitch ass nigga.
And here is his opponent, Vadim Trikhamirovs, also of Latvia, a couple years older, about 1 centimeter shorter, and as I mentioned, 13 kilograms lighter. Made his debut in February of 2015, and so far his record is critical.
Trikhamirovs, Latvia. Ladies and gentlemen, professional boxing fights. Fighting out of the blue corner, 29 years old, official height 189 centimeter, official weight 108 kilogram. His professional record, 9 wins, 7 losses. Representing Grand Boxing Promotion, Latvia, Eriks AK-47 Kalashnikovs. Fighting out of the red corner, 31 years old, official height 180 centimeter, official weight 95 kilogram. His professional record 2 wins, 12 losses. From Latvia, Vadim Trikhamirovs. Ring referee Vladislav Kadikis. 8 rounds, 3 minutes each.
Well, I said this one has the potential to be a slugfest. It, honestly, it could be a one-sided slugfest here. If you ask me, keep your eye on Kalashnikov in the red and blue. This kid has got some serious power. And unfortunately for his opponent, he is not good at taking too many shots. He's been knocked out 12 times in his career. I should mention he's only got 15 fights, so that should tell you something. Backs him up with a couple of jabs, looking to go downstairs. Kalashnikov looking to get into range. You can tell that he is obviously much stockier, let's say, than his opponent, but there only appears to be a 1-inch height differential between these two, but it does just appear to me that Trikhamirovs is the longer of the fighter. It seems like he's just got longer legs, longer arms, a longer abdomen He's just a much taller, lankier fighter than his opponent. Ooh, right hand goes in around the corner, and this is not where Tohimiro's wants to be. He cannot afford to be trapped up against the ropes or in the corner like that, because if Kolesnikov starts to tee off, then this one's going to be history. Ooh, solid body work going in that time. Trying to set him up for the big right. Misses that time with the big right hand. Closing down the ring now. This is where he wants to be. If you're Kolesnikov, that's exactly where you want to be. You want to work your way in, cut down the ring, and then get to work with those big shots. Nice jab downstairs to the body that time. Inside 30 seconds now in this opening round. This one's scheduled for 6 rounds. So should we need them? Ooh. Starting to unload now. One of the advertisements has flown into the ring and it has just been kicked out the back door.
Time.
Well, there's a good action there between these two heavyweights.
Your hands now.
Obviously, you can just feel the tension there. There's some anticipation just kind of hanging in the air when you've got a guy like Kolesnikov, who's known for his big, powerful punches, and a guy like Tihomirov, who's not known for taking big, heavy shots very well. Kolesnikov was doing a good job of walking his opponent down and trying to land those big power punches, but has not landed the big one yet. Is round two the round where we finally see it?
Second round.
I see some adjustments have been made here between rounds one and two. Two Latvian heavyweights going out of here. Kolesnikov now, a bit more aggressive, as is his opponent. So business starting to pick up here in round two. Good right hand. That was a solid shot that time. Ooh, and a left hand snuck in and popped him on the jaw. And there's a right hand. The big one finally found the mark. Trying to sneak that right hand again around the corner. It may have clipped him just on the far side of his glove, maybe in the ear. There's that shot again. Looking for the body now. Oh, you better be careful what you wish for, because you just might get it. There's the right hand in the temple area, and it looks like Tihomirov's just egging him on now. Ooh, nice right. The best shot of the fight so far by Tihomirov. Maybe he's starting to feel confident now. Maybe he's starting to feel like, hey, I've taken this guy's punch a couple of times now, and I'm still standing, so if that's all he's got, then come on and give me some more. Can't afford, though, just to kind of hang out there in that corner. He's got to keep moving here. Ducks under that shot. Oh, but the left caught him. The left caught him.
Three, four, five, six, seven.
The fight will continue, though. About 40 seconds left here now in round number two between these big heavyweights. And again, getting caught on the ropes. Still moving, though. Still ducking. Still trying to avoid those shots. And a clubbing right hand lands. Boy, these two, as I said, starting to open up now. Both men opening up here in round number two. I said this one had the potential to be a slugfest. End of round two. It's like walking out onto a frozen lake. Once you start to tread a little bit closer towards the center of the lake, you start to find yourself walking on very thin ice. I think in round number two, we saw the ice start to crack, and it may just be a matter of time here in round number three before somebody finally falls through. Well, the left jab there, finding a home for Tihomirov's over and over again. But again, he's getting the ring cut down and good body work going in. That one may have been a little bit below the belt, actually. That's not going to count as a knockdown, as that one was below the belt. But he's got the right idea. He's walking down his opponent, and he's getting inside, and once he does get in there, he's taking full advantage. He needs to use more lateral movement here. He can't just afford to be moved straight back. And at this point, feels that he needs to take a knee again. That is the second time now in this fight that Tihomirov has gone down. Is he going to make it this time? Still wants to go. We are in round number three. This one's scheduled for six rounds, folks. Will we need them or not? Oh, solid shot that time. A good right hook and another one. He buckled his legs. Oh, he's firing back now. Tihomirov is not done yet, and a good left jab scores as well. Look at him starting to open up now with whatever's left. It's do or die time. Trying to cover up. A lot of those shots not going in cleanly. They're still going in, but not square on the body. And for the third time now, for the third time in the fight, Tihomirov goes down, and this time it's over for good. Well, let's take another look here, folks. There was, I think, three total knockdowns in this fight. And that was the finishing touches right there. Put on by AK-47, Erikas Kalashnikov. It was a slow, methodical pace in this one. by Kalashnikov, but a strategy that certainly paid off in the end. Rytis Kuzmenka has the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, KOK Fight Series 2019, live on KOKFights.tv. Professional boxing fight. A third round after 2 minutes, 1 second, by technical knockout. The winner is... Blue corner, Eric AK-47, Kalashnikov!
Well, not an overwhelmingly surprising victory there on the part of Kalashnikov, but still an interesting fight to watch and see how things unfolded through three rounds. When we come back, we go back to kickboxing rules and we will have a Baltic title fight under amateur rules coming up.
Shot the sheriff in the slip.